Sean contracted a virulent bug that attacked the soft tissue. By the time he came to Wascana, he had many, many months healing in the general hospital and still several weeks before the tissue was able to bear the pressures necessary in prosthetics.
I went into a coma for 9 days. I don't really remember. I spent 4 months in the hospital, in and out, and then eventually I got sent here.
Well, it happened on Sunday night when he got into the hospital there in Kenora. He experienced a flu-like symptoms before that. On Saturday night, he came home with a fever and shakes. Sunday morning, he couldn't move at all. And then we got him to go to the bathroom and we turned on the light and he was already modeling. So his lips were blue and his nose were blue and he was completely white. As soon as that happened, his mom took him into Kenora Hospital. They wouldn't allow his mom into the ambulance bed because they expected him to die on the way there. And so she drove behind them. He seemed to be doing better, but then he started to crash and he stopped breathing. And so they had to put him on life support and they put him in a medical induced coma for 9 days. He had a 20% chance of survival. And then they said if he did survive it, it wouldn't be the same.
They were trying to see if they could get everything to work and just amputate as little as possible, but the end had to be my blow knee and a blow wrist and just above my toes.
Once he was ready for a prosthesis, we assess what he's left with. I believe an important question is to ask them what they want the prosthesis to do, because everybody has their own lifestyles. So the first thing was to get Sean up and to learn to walk again and how to use his upper limb prosthesis. The assessment is done, and that's done in conjunction with physiotherapy and a physiatrist who is a specialist in rehab medicine, and then we'll design what he needs. After we cast him, I'll take his cast into the plaster room and modify it. Certain areas of the anatomy take pressure well and some areas do not take pressure well, depending upon underlying structures, bones, nerves, those sorts of things. And then we come into this room, the oven room, and we make what's called a test socket or a preparatory socket. It's a clear plastic socket that we can see right through and assess the fit without having to guess. Because we're all built differently, the prosthesis needs to be aligned, much like aligning a tire, to make sure that the leg is walking as smoothly as we possibly can get. Sean was a young guy. He was, I think, 18, 19 years old when this happened. You know, it came as an absolute shock that one day I'm an active young dad and the next minute I'm fighting for my life. So, you know, Sean is not that unusual. My clients come in, they can be depressed, they can be in denial. They've had medical failure after medical failure, and we're some of the first people that can offer them some hope for the future.